Hey everyone! In this tutorial, we're going to look at Java constructor chaining. If you remember in the last video, we ran into problems initializing our class. We were setting the same starting yard line in every constructor in our football game. Our concern was, if the rules of the football game changed again, we would need to check every Java constructor to make sure we're setting the value correctly.
We could set the value as a constant, which would reduce the number of places we need to refactor. That would be a good solution. Let's assume, though, we have the requirement to play according to different football rules for different years. We need to calculate the correct starting position based on the year. That means a constant's not going to work for us. We'll start by creating a method that provides the starting yard line for a given year. This will return the value we need to initialize our game class. So now we can set the value, but we're still not solving our problem. We are actually in a worse position. We could forget to update a constructor, and now in one place we're using a constant, the other one we're using a method. What we really want to do is set the value in one place and only once. What we need to do is call one constructor from another constructor. This is called constructor chaining. We're chaining our constructors together and calling each one in order before returning a created instance. We do that by using the this keyword as a method. The this keyword looks for another constructor matching the argument list we provide. There's a few gotchas though. If the parameter list does not match a constructor, our code's not going to compile. And of course, we cannot have multiple constructors with the same parameter list, even if the parameter names are different. Java wouldn't let us do that even if we didn't chain constructors. The this keyword also only works with constructors for the current class. We cannot use it to call constructors in our superclass. To do that, we'd use the super keyword to call the parent class. When we do use it, it must be the first line in the constructor. We also cannot do this more than once, meaning you cannot call more constructors once you've called another constructor. You only get one call. And the big gotcha is we cannot chain constructors in a way that it could create a loop. Java won't even let us compile constructors with a loop. We'll get an exception. When we create our constructor chain, we need to keep the chain in a straight line as much as possible. An inverted tree would work too, but that can get complicated for other developers to figure out what's going on if it gets too big. Ultimately, our constructor chain should end up at a single constructor. That constructor should be the only constructor responsible for returning an instance. We can create multiple independent chains, but that gets confusing too. The best practice is one chain with one ending. A classic pattern for chaining constructors is to perform one initialization step each time. The starting constructor sets everything to a default value. Then each constructor adds one bit of information based on its parameter. If we have a situation where the constructor path is simple, or if we could always have initialization values known in a particular order, chaining constructors works great.
Of course, there's a slight problem with this. What if we have only 3 of 5 parameters? There's no real good way to jump in the middle of a chain or skip constructors. We'll need another approach. In the next tutorial, we'll look at something called the builder pattern to solve our initialization order problem. All right, well, thanks for watching. If you have any questions, let me know in the comments. New videos come out every week, so make sure you subscribe. You don't want to miss a video. If you're trying to get to the DJU.com website right now, it's down for the next week for a site update. Videos will still be posted here on YouTube. And with that, I'll see you in the next tutorial.